the prophet about the song. Oh Lord, how long shall I cry? And you will not hear, even cry out to you violence, and you will not say, why do you show me iniquity and cause me to see trouble? For plundering and violence are before me. There is strife and contention arise. Therefore the law is powerless and justice never goes forth. For the wicked surround the righteous. Therefore perverse judgment proceeds. Turn to chapter 2. Then the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. Make it plain on the tablets, that he may run who reads it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time. But at the end it will speak, and it will not lie. Though it tarries, wait for it. Because it will surely come. It will not tarry. Behold, the proud, his soul is not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith. Turn to chapter 3. Verse 17. Though the fig tree may not blossom, nor fruit be on the vines, though the labor of the olives may fail, and the fields yield no food, though the flock may be cut off from the fold, and there be no herds in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will joy in the God of my salvation. The Lord God is my strength. I can sit down.
Yes, sir.
The word of God can preach itself. But for a theme, and I showed it to Reverend Lovett before I got up. My theme today, Reverend Truxton, is God is. The theme today, Deacon Hubbard, God is. Church, our theme today is God is. Our God and our Father, thank you. We felt your presence all day long. Now, Lord, have your way as the man of God stands before the people of God to usher in the word of God. Get the glory, get the honor, and get the praise. Thank you for the deliverance that's already been taking place. Thank you for the healing that has already taken place. But, Lord, empower your word that we will know that we have the power to overcome any situation in our lives. Because we serve a God who is able and who is. So thank you, Lord, for what you're about to do in our presence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. If there was ever a time we needed the Lord, it sure is right now. My God, there is so much happening around us and in the world. Every day there seems to be some issue we are dealing with. Right now, while we're sitting in service in the house of the Lord, somebody has their mind on their problem or their situation. Thinking about something, children, job, spouse, money situation, parents, because the struggle is real. We're living in some difficult times. Trump is losing a little bit of mind he has.
Amen.
And we're turning lies into truth.
Amen.
Alternative facts.
What are we to do? With all that's going on today, somebody may be wondering, where is God? Whatever you're dealing with, you may be wondering, where is God? You are now in the text. You are where Habakkuk is. He's in the text, and he's dealing with some complex and confusing issues. What he's dealing with is the contrasting forces that are between justice and injustice, confidence and doubt, salvation and judgment, and God and humanity. God's people are under judgment. The Chaldeans are on the move. These are some wicked and powerful forces coming down on the southern kingdom of Judah. And Habakkuk is worried, like many of us today, that his world is on the verge of destruction. And is in trouble. He's concerned, he's worried, and he has some doubts and some fears. Yes, sir. And so he takes his concerns to the Lord. All right. He calls on the Lord. Oh Lord! How long? How long shall I cry and you will not hear me? His question to God is, God, do you really care? Somebody knows what he's talking about. That's a relevant question for some of you this morning. You want to know, where is God? He's calling out to the Lord. Oh Lord, how long? Like some of us, you've been crying out, Lord, how long? How long will I have to deal with this situation? Lord, how long will I have to deal with doctors and medications? Lord, how long before I find a job that I can take care of my family? Lord, how long will I have to deal with the trouble I'm in? For Habakkuk, this is not a prayer. This is a dialogue with God. He's showing us that we can have a conversation with our Heavenly Father. It's all right to ask God questions, to be honest about your feelings, to tell God about your doubts and your worries. He has a conversation with God, and we can do the same.
All right.
You ought to have a conversation with God. Every now and then, I just talk to God. God, what you doing? I know you don't have to tell me, but I'm going to ask because I need to know what you're doing, Lord. What you're doing in my life. What you're doing in this situation. I need to know. How long, Lord? See, y'all on the other side, but remember when you were in it and going through it and didn't know when you come out and didn't know what God was doing? Well, somebody's there right now. I know I receive new mercies every day, but how long, Lord? Yeah. Yeah. Lord, I just buried one person, and now I got to turn around. How long, Lord? Yeah. Don't know how strong I am, Lord. Don't know how much I can handle. But I don't have anywhere else to go. Will answer. Chapter 2, God answers Habakkuk. He tells him to write the vision down. Make it plain. And his vision is for an appointed time. Wait for it. For it will surely come. A vision from God is a reliable pledge that God will act in the future. That's what a vision is. And that should make somebody good, feel good today. That should be good news because God is declaring in your situation, he's still God. God is saying to us, I'm still in control.
Yeah.
Nothing happens without my permission or without my will or without my knowledge. I know you may not understand it now, but be patient. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean not to your own understanding. He said, be patient. Do not give up on me. Do not despair. Do not worry. You may have some doubt. You may have some fear, but God knows your uprising. He knows your down cities. He knows you don't cross all your T's or dot all your I's. He knows your heart may not be upright, but he declares the faith of you, the goodness of the Lord, those who know the Lord shall live by what? Faith.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
No matter who you are, what you're going through, if you can just hold on to your faith. If you want God to move in your situation, you must have faith. God tells Habakkuk, you need faith to make it to and through the vision. Don't quit.
All right.
Don't quit. All right. Pastoral ministry for me has been a 20-year journey. Didn't know where I would wind up. But I saw the vision.
Yeah, yeah.
I didn't give up.
Yeah.
All right.
Some of you have had a vision and you forgot it. Hold on to the vision. God wants us to have faith. He wants you to hold on to your faith in him. Not your job, not your money, not your education, not your friends, but in him. We must take God at his word. If God said it,
yeah,
it shall come to pass. If God said it, it is so. Faith says it is so. Faith believes that it is so. I may not have it, but God said it, it shall come to pass. I wish I had a witness. God got some blessings with your name on it. It is so. I wish I had somebody. And you and I was talking about it. Faith releases the power to bless life.
Yeah.
Faith. But sometimes it's a test. There will be times when your faith will be tested. There will be times when your faith will be challenged. There will be times when you will want to question God about what he's doing. There are times when your faith will have to come into practice. What faith is what you use at the time you need it the most. I get a little upset when I run into Christians who say they have faith. But when the time comes to have faith, they don't use the faith. It's synonymous with a parachute. If you jump out of a plane and fall with a parachute and don't open it, you're going to die. Whatever you in life, dealing with in life, you've got to apply faith. Faith will move God. Faith should kick in when it looks like no way out. Faith should kick in when you have nowhere else to go but to look up. Faith should kick in because faith is determined that God can do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me bring it up. Faith says God will.
Yeah.
Faith says God will be my comforter.
Yeah.
Faith says God will be my healer.
Yeah.
Faith says God will be my keeper.
Yeah.
Faith says God will make a way out of no way. Faith believes God. He said it, and therefore I believe it.
Yeah.
If he said I'll never leave you, he means he'll never leave you. If he says I will heal you, he means I will heal you. If he says that I will work it out, he will work it out. Faith will tell you God will do it.
Yeah.
And I believe the word of God.
Thank you, Lord.
Faith in God will change your perspective about God. Look at chapter 2. Habakkuk ends the second chapter with a change in his approach to God. Look at verse 20. his perspective changes. He says, the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. Help me out, preacher. The Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth keep silent before him. Help me out, preacher. The Lord is in his holy temple. Ain't time for doubt. The Lord is in his holy temple. Ain't time for worry. Oh Lord, in chapter 3, I heard your report. I've written the vision down. I got it, Lord. And now I need to recognize who you are. He's worshiping God for who God is and for what he's already done. And I've come to tell somebody this morning, if you just remember how far God has already brought you. Not forgetting those things, but remembering where he has you right now. And that ought to push a few of y'all, that ought to kick a few of y'all into the next phase of your life, because if he brought you this far, and he's got you right here, right now, he's willing to push you by faith to the next level. Let me say that one more time. Forget just how bad off we were, just how lost we were, just how in trouble we were. We forget just how far we got, have come through the grace of God, because we look good now, we smell good now, we forget how we used to be, how we hung the streets, how we ran around and anything we want. We in church now, because we in church now, we don't need the call of the Lord like we did when we were out there. But when I think of the goodness of Jesus, it reminds me where I am right now. And then it gives me an option to go forward. Because if I can just go forward, knowing the same God who brought me from here, has me here, will take me further. I wish I had somebody knew what I was talking about. He begins to praise God. Here's the blessing. Nothing had changed except his faith. Have you changed your faith? I dare you to show up Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, 6 a.m. and bring your faith. It'll be transformed. He begins to praise God, but nothing has changed except his perspective of who God is. That's why I don't worry. My God is bigger than anything that I will face on this level. Did you hear what I said? That's the perspective we got to get. That's the perspective we have to have. Your God is bigger! He turns his doubts into a shout. Yes, he does. He turns his doubts. Y'all ready to shout? Look at verse 17. Though the fig tree shall not flourish, neither shall fruit be on the vine. The labor of the harvest fail, and the fields yield no food. And though the flock be cut off from the fold, and there be no herd in the stall, yet will I rejoice in the Lord. about praising God. There is something about giving God praise. It will change your look and your perspective and your situation. I wish I had somebody. Oh, praise His holy name. But whenever you feel overwhelmed, I dare you to praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I had it in my text.
Hallelujah.
I close out the same way we started. Thank you, Reverend Clark.
Yeah, yeah.
The songwriter said, God is the joy and the strength of my life.
Yeah,
yeah. He moves all pain,
yes,
misery, yeah, and strife.
Yeah.
He promised to keep me, yeah, never to leave me. He's never, ever, 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 when he comes back, I'm coming.
Right now,
he's delivering some right now, but you got enough for yourself, God.